This is ABC 7 News at Noon. Your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Good afternoon, I'm Ray Collins. Topping our news, it is the strongest hurricane to hit land in over 10 years in this country. Hurricane Harvey has dropped 20 inches of rain, and twice that amount is still expected. The weather has caused the evacuation of some 30,000 people in Houston. And now here's a new problem, snakes and alligators. The latest from ABC's Maggie Rulli.
The country's fourth largest city remains underwater. With more heavy rain expected, the city could be soaked with up to 50 inches.
This is a landmark event. We have not seen an event like this. You could not draw this forecast up. You could not dream this forecast up.
And today, a new problem. Officials say city dams built to protect downtown Houston against a 1,000-year flooding event are nearing capacity. The reservoirs rising at more than 4 inches an hour.
We have dam safety experts monitoring these structures 24/7.
To control the flooding, the Army Corps of Engineers will begin releasing the dams, but first have to evacuate residents whose homes could get flooded.
Those are in the neighborhoods that are going to be challenged over the next couple of hours and the next couple of days.
Floodwaters are rising rapidly, bringing snakes and alligators right to the front door, forcing entire apartment buildings to flee to the roof.
It's like 30 of us on the roof. Across the street, the building is caving in and it's water everywhere. We have nowhere to go.
Half of the country's Coast Guard helicopters are in Texas, and they've rescued more than 2,000 people already. FEMA has at least 900 search and rescue operators on the ground, but still they're calling on citizens to help their neighbors.
People were screaming out, help, help, help. You know, we'll come back for you. Next thing you know, there's 20 different people you've rescued.
With more bands of heavy rain expected over the next few days, the community will have to rely on each other once again. Officials say Harvey has already affected about a quarter of Texas, nearly 7 million people. And it's those same communities like here in Houston that are expected to get hit with even more rain. Maggie Rulli, ABC News, Houston, Texas.
New at noon back in this area, heavy rain flooded a school bus full of students in Venice this morning. This is a picture of the incident. Look at that. It happened in the 700 block of East Venice Avenue about 7 a.m. Police rescued three special needs high school students and two adults. All are fine now. Police are urging anyone driving in the area between U.S. 41 bypass and Bay Indies to use caution because of that flooding. Also in Venice, heavy rain from the weekend and last night have also prompted the city to close several roads. The closures are now on your screen. Venice Avenue Bridge, the 1,000 block of Pinebrook to Ridgewood Avenue, Ponce de Leon and South Harbor Drive, and Bahama Road between the Venice Performing Arts Center and Venice Elementary. All fountains in the city, including the Children's Fountain in Centennial Park, are closed. Also, sandbags and shovels are being passed out at Flamingo Drive, Gardenia Drive in Venice. For a full list of road closures, go to our website, mysuncoast.com. And in Manatee County, two county roads are closed due to water spilling onto the road. They are Whitfield Avenue from Lockwood Ridge to Tuttle and Prospect Road from 63rd to Whitfield. One Manatee County neighborhood is experiencing waist-high water and dozens of families unable to go home. At least 40 families have been evacuated in the Center Lake neighborhood off of Prospect and Whitfield. FPNL cut power and some residents experienced 10 to 12 inches of water inside their homes. The flooding began late Friday, and by Saturday morning, emergency workers brought in a special high-water military vehicle to evacuate the residents.
It came in so quick at 1 in the morning, we had nothing, there was nothing we could do. We just tried to put stuff as high as we could, but it came in so fast, it was hard to react.
It's a devastating event. It's just, you can't even hardly think straight. It moves so quickly.
I mean, we've been in a community 23 years, and this has never happened.
Emergency officials say water is not expected to recede until later in the week. Also, parts of Myakka State Park are closed today due to flooding. Water is at least knee-high there. The flooding is impacting local wildlife.
Well, you'll see a lot of wildlife in places that you don't normally see it, but they're used to this. They know where the high ground is, and you won't see quite as much. There's a lot of gators crossing the road trying to find a spot to be.
Park officers say this is the highest they've seen the water there, and they're expecting at least another foot of rain. Portions of the park will remain closed until the waters have receded. In Sarasota County, government workers are passing out sandbags at three locations. They are at Newtown Estates Park on Newtown Boulevard. You can pick up the sandbags until 5 o'clock today. Also closed today, Twin Lakes Park on Clark Road and the South County Fleet Facility on Englewood Road in Venice. Also Ted Sperling Park on South Lido, Casperson Beach and Sharkies. All South County fields are also closed due to the flooding. You know, for a brief moment today, about 10 a.m., I saw a blink of sunshine.
Right, I know. Yeah, we have a little bit of sunshine trying to peek out there.
But
I think on Wednesday, you're really going to like the skies, though, because we're going to see a lot of sunshine around. Actually, that sunshine may not be of benefit to us today, though, because it could actually just help to build a few more clouds and better chances of some stronger storms. You know, this morning on the Sunrise Show, we declared today a first alert weather day. Mm-hmm. And to show you the reason why, we have some, again, today, a flood watch in effect for our area. And, of course, flood warnings for some of the rivers out there. We'll talk more about that in a few. We had some very heavy rainfall this morning, as you heard in previous stories on this broadcast. And we have a lot of light rain out there currently. We just finished with one stronger storm that has now dissipated in inland areas. Still have a chance today at seeing some stronger storms around, even though right now just a lot of light rain out there making the roads slippery. But look at the satellite view. You'll see the clouds building. There's lots of moisture around. The heat of the day helping to build those clouds. Certainly possible that we could see some more storms around that could produce rainfall rates of half an inch an hour or so. And over the last 24 hours, radar estimates of rainfall over 2 inches in many locations. So the ground's still obviously completely saturated. Any additional heavy rain, and it's possible today, could lead to some more localized street flooding. In any event, it's going to be kind of a rainy, drizzly afternoon at times, with maybe a peek at the sun from time to time. Ray?
All right, John, talk to you again soon. Thank you. Happening today, in fact, next hour, a Bradenton man accused of killing his girlfriend and their infant son is making his first appearance in court at 1 o'clock this afternoon. 20-year-old Larry Williams faces 2 counts of murder and 1 count of arson. He is suspected in the deaths of 18-year-old Diamond Shellman and their 8-month-old son, Jeremiah. Their bodies were found at the Avalon Square Apartments early yesterday morning on 14th Street West near 35th Avenue. When firefighters arrived, flames were coming from the apartment. The cause of the fire and an investigation of the deaths is still ongoing. Also in Manatee County, police in Palmetto need your help to find a man suspected of an attempted murder at a convenience store. An arrest warrant has been issued for this man, Lazandias Randall Jr. Police say he is considered armed and dangerous, so if you do see him, do not approach him. Instead, call the police or Crime Stoppers at 866-634-TIPS. Time now for our first check on Wall Street. Richard Stern joins us. And Richard, so far it looks like it's off to a mixed start.
Ray, you're exactly right. Mixed is the word. The Dow Jones Industrial Average has been as high as plus 47 and as low as minus 44. The Dow is in negative territory. The NASDAQ, frankly, pretty strong with tech stocks making a good rebound. So all in all, yes, it's a mixed morning. Let's take a look at a mixed morning Monday. And in fact, there you see the Dow down 25 points, just 12/100ths. 1% at 21,788.47 on volume of 318 million shares. The NASDAQ is higher by 0.33%, almost 21 points at 6,286.28, that on volume of 641 million shares. The S&P barely budged, up 0.01%, 0.04%, at 2,443.89. Well, Uber has a new CEO. This morning, Uber announced they have hired a 48-year-old Iranian-American. There you see him. I apologize. I cannot pronounce his name, but maybe we'll learn how to do that. Nonetheless, he has been hired to turn around Uber, as people think turnaround is needed. He beat out no less than Jeffrey Immelt, the outgoing chairman of General Electric, and Meg Whitman, who is the chairman of Hewlett-Packard. So obviously this man comes with very, very high credentials. The previous CEO was asked to leave in June. It took them only until August to find a new gentleman. And Ray, this gentleman's last name, and I apologize, has more letters in it than I can count. So, but he's got to be a pretty smart guy and pretty qualified.
Must be. You're very honest to admit you can't pronounce the guy's name.
Not a chance.
All right. Thank you, Richard Stern. I can say that.
There you go.
See you back here at 5 o'clock.
I'll be here.
All right. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Still to come on your Suncoast News, some of the candidates running for Florida's next governor are meeting face-to-face today in Palm Beach. And mothers often hear that breast milk is best for their baby, and there's new reason why. That's next in Health Smart.
The ABC7 Stock Report is brought to you by Sunset Cadillac. Hurricane season is here, and so is the ABC7 First Alert Hurricane Guide. This essential resource arms you with vital information you need to protect your family and property when severe weather threatens the Suncoast, including how to create your readiness plan and survival kit, shelter locations, what to do with your pets, and important phone numbers. Visit mysuncoast.com and download the ABC7 First Alert Hurricane Guide. Brought to you by Batteries Plus, the Florida Lottery, and Sarasota Glass and Mirror.
Hi, I'm Chef Bob. Watch Aprons in the Kitchen every Wednesday morning on ABC7, where we'll be serving up the most awesome dishes. Then stop by your neighborhood Publix, pick up the recipe card and all the ingredients.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today. Sleep on it tonight.
Jacuzzi is proud to present our first ever safe bathing event. The Jacuzzi walk-in tub allows you or a loved one to take a safe and relaxing bath. Never climb in and out of a regular bathtub again. Our walk-in tub offers a low step-in threshold, fast drain technology, soothing hydrotherapy, and even a shower handle. Regain bathing independence with a Jacuzzi walk-in tub and enjoy spending more time with loved ones. Why wait any longer? During our safe bathing event, save $750 on a new walk-in tub, receive $250 in safety upgrades, and a $100 Visa gift card. But if you call right now during this program, we'll double the savings to $1,500, double the safety upgrades to $500, and double it to a $200 Visa gift card with your walk-in tub purchase. Call right now to save double on a new walk-in tub. Call now.
Watch your Suncoast News at 6 on your streaming device for a chance to win a $50 Visa. It's easy. Just watch weekdays at 6 for the word of the week. Then enter the word at mysuncoast.com for your shot at a $50 Visa. We'll pick the winner each week. Good luck. ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights. Now your ABC 7 First Alert weather forecast with meteorologist John Scalzi.
Okay, so here's my picture of the day. This is the Myakka River flow rate taken from the Myakka Gauge, which is pretty close to 72 in the Myakka State Park. Here we are just a few days ago, and then the rain started. And look, we went from a discharge rate of a few hundred cubic feet per minute to about 3,000 cubic feet per minute. Because of all that rainfall. It is, again, forecast to crest about Wednesday or so, just about at the minimum value of a historic level. So that's pretty impressive. In Myakka State, it shouldn't bother anybody. Peace River near Arcadia, though, may see some flooding of the Royal Acres homes. It's a possibility. We'll watch that pretty carefully. That starts, again, on Wednesday. Then it'll probably start tapering off in Thursday or so. A slow rate, but boy, some very, very fast stream flows around. 82 degrees, our current air temperature. We've got some light drizzle in progress. The air dew point temperature, rather, is at 79. You can see all of the rain showers around. Light stuff for the most part now. We have had some periods of some heavier rain, and of course, the ground completely saturated. If you get some of these heavier rainstorms moving through, it's pretty likely that you'll see, at least temporarily, some standing water on roadways. That combined with the fact that over the next 24 hours, computer models are still suggesting that we could have some isolated pockets of 2-inch-plus rainfalls has caused me to today designate this a first alert weather day. I think it's reasonable. A frontal boundary to the north of us sinking south, and
very slowly, and a area of disturbed weather off the Jacksonville coast. This has been termed a potential tropical cyclone. The reason they call it a potential tropical cyclone is because it may become a tropical cyclone very quickly. It may become a depression or a tropical storm. And if it does so, there wouldn't be enough time for watches or warnings to be issued for the areas that need to have watches and warnings issued. In this case, we have some tropical storm watches up for areas of South Carolina and North Carolina coastline. Just in case this does indeed actually develop into something stronger, it'll have a very brief period of time for that to happen before upper level winds kind of tear it apart and it becomes absorbed. But in the meantime, it's helping to produce this nice flow off of Gulf waters, this long fetch of air that's producing tropical atmosphere across the Sun Coast. And with a little daytime heating, I think it's pretty likely that we'll get some more stronger storms this afternoon. We'll see how that plays out. Another 2 to 4 inches are possible over the next day or so. And then less rain tomorrow. We'll start trending down rain chances, but the sun will really start to return, I think, on Wednesday. So a couple of systems, one off the coast of Africa, plenty of time to watch that. The one I just talked about, and of course, Harvey. Harvey taking the worst imaginable track in terms of producing heavy rainfall for Texas. But this one off our coast, off the Jacksonville coast, all models agree it heads out into open waters, but could skirt the Carolina coastline. We'll see. Our forecast calling for about a 70% chance of at least some rain and showers throughout the afternoon, kind of aggravating the situation, but also potentially some isolated pockets of some heavy downpours. So we'll watch for that. Tomorrow we start to trend the rain chances down, and then starting Wednesday, rest of the work week looks pretty good, Ray.
All right, John, thanks very much. Welcome back. On to our health news now. New research may give mothers one more reason to breastfeed. Scientists say it's a compound called hyaluronic acid, or HA. It can be useful in helping some common causes of inflammatory bowel diseases like Crohn's and colitis. It's also been shown to be effective in fighting salmonella bacteria. The research is still in its early stages, but doctors say the possibility of using a substance like HA to treat disease or infection is appealing because it's natural.
It's such an attractive thing because it's not an antibiotic. What it does is turn on the body's innate, you know, inborn mechanisms to protect itself.
So doctors are now using their work to fund another study to see if HA is effective against bacteria such as C. diff and E. coli. And on that lovely note, let's talk about food and find out what Chef Judy has for us today.
You know, I love eggplant. A lot of health benefits to it. It's light, especially if you don't fry it and bread it. So I have a version of an eggplant rollatini that I think you'll really enjoy, filled with ricotta cheese, sun-dried tomatoes, basil, and we're going to bring that together with a little ripe lemon arugula salad to go on top. It's going to be perfect. You can eat it at room temperature, bring it to work the next day, and it's great if you're getting together for a book club. So stay with me throughout the hour as we make a healthier version of eggplant rollatini. I think you're going to enjoy. I certainly know I will. I'll be back in just a few minutes to get started.
What to do when your heating or air conditioning needs service or, heaven forbid, replacement? Call Air Now today. We've been serving Sarasota and Manatee counties since 1946. We offer $49.95 tune-ups, lease or finance options, and remember, service today or it's free.
Attention Sarasota and surrounding cities. After 25 years in Sarasota, Bacon's Furniture and Design will be moving to create Southwest Florida's largest and most dynamic furniture store. We must liquidate everything in the store at huge savings as fast as possible. Do not miss this opportunity to purchase quality sofas, bedrooms, dining rooms, patio furniture, mattresses, and more, all at the absolute lowest prices possible. The Bacon's Furniture and Design relocation sell-off. Nobody beats Bacon's.
Attention, Americans eligible for Medicare. Are you getting all the benefits you're entitled to? Did you know there may be money available to lower your medical prescription costs? Call Health Markets and we'll tell you if you qualify.
Hi, I'm Dr. Martin Jeetze. It's a new Medicare year. That means more changes and more confusion. The key question is, what can you do now to ensure you get the care you need in the coming year?
Call Health Markets today. You may qualify to save money on prescriptions. We'll help you find plans that may cost less, cover more, and could even lower your prescription costs. to increase your savings. We help you find all the benefits you're entitled to, and we do it at no cost.
Make sure you have what you need to get the care that's right for you.
Find out if you qualify to receive extra help with your prescriptions. Call the number on the screen now. Representatives are standing by.
Are you a food lover, restaurant goer, or home cook? Then check out My Suncoast Dining on MySuncoast.com, your guide to the foodie lifestyle. ABC 7's own Chef Judy serves up her favorite recipes, cooking tips and trends, dining blogs, and helpful step-by-step videos. And you'll love the restaurant guide with direct links to your favorite Suncoast eateries. Whether you're cooking in or dining out, whet your appetite with tasty tips from Chef Judy at MySuncoast.com/dining.
Watch your Suncoast News at 6 on your streaming device for a chance to win a $50 Visa. It's easy. Just watch weekdays at 6 for the word of the week. Then enter the word at MySuncoast.com for your shot at a $50 Visa. We'll pick the winner each week. Good luck. ABC 7 News at 7, weeknights.
Well, the Rays are getting hot at the right time. Logan Morrison hit his second homer of the game in the 10th. To lead the Rays past the Cardinals 3-2 on Sunday, extra innings. Earlier in the game, Sergio Romo threw a scoreless ninth, and Alex Colom worked a scoreless 10th for his major league leading 39th save and 44 chances. Get this, all five runs in the game were scored on solo home runs. That's unusual. The win was the Rays' third in four games and fifth in seven as they attempt to chase down a wild card spot. Tampa Bay improved also in extra innings to 8-5. On the greens, Dustin Johnson pulled off a stunner over Jordan Spieth in the Northern Trust. The event featured two of the biggest names in golf who put on a show. Johnson rallying from a five-shot deficit on the front nine, and the final hole he curled in an 18-foot birdie putt that swirled around the cup and fell in to match Spieth's two-putt par from 75 feet. Johnson took on the lake with a 341-yard tee shot and then a lob wedge to within 4 feet. And Spieth couldn't make a 25-foot birdie.
We both came up short on most of the holes we played on the front nine until we started to kind of fire to it on 10.
A lot of my wins, usually I've just had to like two putt on 18 or, you know, had an easy go at it. This was the first one I really had to work at. And, you know, so it was... You know, it was nice. It was good to make the putt, you know, especially when I really needed to make one.
Yeah, Johnson rolled it in for his fourth victory of the year. With the win, he continues his streak as the world's top golfer. Floyd Mayweather says he is done in the ring now, 2 days after he beat mixed martial artist Conor McGregor. Mayweather said he's going to stop with a record of 15-0. The 40-year-old tired out McGregor until the referee called the fight after a flurry of Mayweather punches in the 10th. The pay-per-view event was one of the most watched in history. There's already calls for a rematch. Stay tuned. A little more peaceful in Judy's kitchen. She's making an eggplant rollatini today. Judy?
Working with eggplant can be really easy. If you're going to be using it for eggplant parmesan or eggplant rollatini, you want to use a mandolin. I mean, you can find one that's not too expensive, but make sure you use the guard. And you're going to slice it the lengthwise once you take off that initial stem. What's important to work with eggplant is you want to get some of the water out, because otherwise it'll just fill your casserole dish. Two ways of doing this. One, I have some regular sliced if I want to turn it into eggplant parmesan or use it for a sandwich, and I have it cut lengthwise. We're going to season it with salt, coarse salt, and let it sit for about 15 minutes. That's going to drain a lot of the moisture out of the eggplant, make it sweat. And then what I do is I just layer it in this colander for a little bit, and that can sit as the moisture comes out so it doesn't get on your counter. And that's going to work out fine. So we'll do that, like I said, for 15 minutes. Let that start to drain. When it does, it's going to look like this. So then what we're going to do is we're going to line up those pieces onto a cookie sheet, whether it's round for a parmesan. Like I said, we're going to give you two recipes this way. Or if it's just going to be the traditional rollatini way. So we're going to pop this in the oven at a low heat just to be able to get a little more moisture out and to get it pliable. It's pretty pliable now, as you can see from using the mandolin, but it's going to be much easier. On these smaller pieces towards the end, for uniformity, just put them to the side. And again, that can be for a baked eggplant sandwich another time. So it sat. It drained, and now it's going to go in the oven, okay? We'll keep an eye on that. Pull it out when we see it just before it browns, but again, it'll come out of the oven. We'll take a paper towel and we'll pat that. Then we're going to get ready to make the ricotta filling. So the first thing, you know I use this sauce a lot of times. It's Michael's from Brooklyn, and I love it. I get over at the Fresh Market. And I love the flavor. And it's, you know, it's just that perfect cheat sauce because our tomatoes locally aren't in right now. If you're gonna make tomato sauce, Yoder's Produce has the aromas and you can simmer that down, but this makes such an easy fix. So I'm gonna layer the bottom with some sauce and a slice of tomato. It's almost like making eggplant caprese, right? When we come back, let's make the filling and I'll show you how to roll them and we'll bake them up and have a delicious lunch.
So many possibilities worth exploring. Manasota Flooring.
Looking for carpet? Look no further. Manasota Flooring has smart strand carpet as low as $1.79 per square foot. Installed, no add-ons or extras. Unbelievable? Manasota Flooring can have in-stock carpet installed in your home in 48 hours for as low as $1.99 per square foot. Don't miss these prices. Visit Manasota Flooring today.
So, you've decided to go to college. That's cool. So, pop quiz. Which is a better way to earn your degree? Commute to college and fill your gas tank, get stuck in traffic, drive in bad weather, try to find a parking space, walk a half mile to class, or learn online at Independence University. In the park on a bench, on the beach on a towel, or on your couch with your kid, your campus is wherever you want it to be. You don't go to college, college goes to you. That's Independence. That's Independence University. You schedule classes around your schedule, and all your supplies, including a brand new laptop and tablet, are included with tuition. At Independence U, you'll learn from professional instructors with real work experience. You'll get personal support in school and employment assistance when you graduate. Get your degree, but keep your life. That's Independence. That's Independence University. So if you're really smart, you'd call now.
Call 1-800-319-0237.
Independence U, for an independent you.
Call 1-800-319-0237.
This is an important medical announcement. Bard IVC filters have been linked to punctured veins and problems with migration. Anyone who's received a Bard IVC filter must receive medical monitoring and may be entitled to substantial compensation. If you have the Bard Recovery G2 or G2 Express filter, you are in a class of patients who should be compensated for some expenses. Call now for a free assessment of your case and potential money damages. This call is confidential. There's no cost and you may be eligible. Juries have awarded millions of dollars to people who should have been warned about the risks of the Bard IVC filters. Call the IVC filter hotline if you or a loved one has received an IVC filter and experienced a vein puncture or required medical monitoring. You must call now.
Call 800-329-3089. 800-329-3089.
It's been about a month, and I can honestly say I've seen the change in me. I went from being a depressed girl who didn't want help to this happy, caring girl who loves helping other people. I just really hope that people that went through what I went through get the help that they need because their story is important and they are loved. Thank you so much for everything.
Live from our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is ABC 7 News at Noon. Your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
And welcome back. All this weather left a mess around a Teamsters Union office on 9th Street East in Bradenton. Look at this. Trees snapped, debris piled up, and workers had to clear a path to get to the front door. A guy named Mike Conforti says he's never seen it this bad before.
When I pulled up, I didn't expect all this. I've been a part of this for 18 years, this organization, and Throughout all the hurricanes, the tropical storms, I've never seen anything like this before.
The storm also caused some roof damage. Fallen trees brought down a power line as well. In Houston, police have already rescued some 2,000 people stranded by Hurricane Harvey. The Federal Emergency Management Agency is asking citizens to get involved. Yeah, the administrator admits the storm and resulting floods are greater than the government can handle.
The bottom line is that it's going to continue on. We need the whole community, not only the federal government forces, but this is a whole community effort from all levels of government, and it's going to require the citizens getting involved.
20 inches of rain have fallen, and at least twice that amount is still predicted, and the rivers won't crest until later in the week. Meantime, a Bradenton couple is responding to the call for action to help storm victims. Carla and Chuck Olson have been Red Cross volunteers for the past few years. They've worked on some local operations within the community, but now they're being asked to travel out of state. They're going to be going now to Baton Rouge, Louisiana, on behalf of the American Red Cross.
No, we were on the list for a deployment, so we called and checked around, and then sure enough, we were the number one and two people they wanted to go. So we volunteered and raised our hands and said we'd go.
This is our first big opportunity, so we're a little nervous and pretty excited to be able to help.
The Olsons will be deployed for 2 weeks in Louisiana before moving on elsewhere, wherever they're needed to help the Red Cross operations. And if you'd like to help those affected by Hurricane Harvey, you can donate to the Red Cross by going to the website redcross.org or text Harvey to 90-999 to make a $10 donation or call 800-RED-CROSS. Well, you never know what you'll see when the floodwaters start to rise. Look at this. A woman in Texas walked outside to find an alligator came up to the front of her home. Quite a surprise indeed. The video was recorded in Missouri City, Texas over the weekend. I'm trying to see it there. Well, John, the thing is 20 inches of rain have fallen already, and you're saying, or the forecasters are saying, much more is expected, and then the rivers will crest. So this is going to get worse before it gets better.
Yeah, it really is. And in fact, in some areas, they've even had more than 20. They've had 30 inches of rainfall.
Right.
And, you know, there's some forecast models predicting as much as 50 inches will fall.
Wow.
And the center of the storm has now moved out over the warm Gulf waters. I mean, like the worst possible thing that thing could do. And it's going to gradually drift northward and then back onto land once again. So it'll make
again.
A second landfall.
Right.
Exactly. And as it sits out there in those warm Gulf waters, it's just going to continue to pump moisture in. A little bit of a dry slot in it right now, but I don't think it's going to do a lot of strengthening. But still, it's going to pump moisture in right into the Houston area.
It's terrible
situation.
Stalled right now.
Yeah, terrible situation.
Yeah.
We have across our region, actually, it's probably good advice after having seen that alligator video to remind folks that stay away from those waters that are above bank full on our area's streams and rivers. You know what? You never know what's in there. You saw pictures of alligators. Ray just showed you. Also snakes. That's a possibility. And certainly even in those waters that are standing that don't maybe have critters in them, you could have broken glass under there. So don't let your kids play in there. Our Van Wezel webcam continues to show those showers moving in from time to time today. Some of them heavy, producing some torrential rains at times. And now we're left with just some minor rainfall across the region. But that could change later in the day as we have some development out in the Gulf. Could see some periods of heavier rain later on. We'll talk about that coming up in a few. Ray?
All right, John. Talk to you soon. Thank you. The latest now from the White House. President Trump spent the weekend at Camp David monitoring the hurricane. It is the first major natural disaster during his presidency. ABC's Emily Rao has more from Washington.
The president is back in Washington today as Texas and Louisiana cope with the aftermath of Harvey. The White House released a photo of President Trump monitoring the storm during a video conference from Camp David. And the president plans an in-person look at the devastation Tuesday. From Texas, good marks for the administration from the state's Republican governor.
The president was very concerned about Texans, but also very dedicated to making sure that we had everything that we needed.
In tweets, the president touting the great coordination and all-out effort. But Trump's focus on Twitter shifting to other topics this morning, including retweeting a quote from Mother Teresa and praise for his pardon of controversial Sheriff Joe Arpaio. But it's not all praise. The president is taking hits for that pardon and the timing of it coming as Harvey approached Texas. Former Vice President Joe Biden, who wrote in The Atlantic, the president's contempt for the U.S. Constitution and willingness to divide this nation knows no bounds.
Well, this is somebody that constantly has talked about healing, 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 but almost every single one of his actions as president has been the exact opposite.
And even Secretary of State Tillerson struggled to defend the president's values.
I don't believe anyone doubts the American people's values or the commitment of the American government or the government's agencies to advancing those values and defending those values.
And the president's values?
The president speaks for himself, Chris.
And as Harvey was approaching, the White House directed the Pentagon to extend a ban on transgender individuals joining the military. This morning, the ACLU filed a challenge to that order in court. Emily Rao, ABC News, Washington.
On to Florida politics now happening today. The race for governor is already heating up. Three leading Democratic candidates are appearing today together in Palm Beach County. Former Congressperson Gwen Graham, Tallahassee Mayor Andrew Gillum, and businessman Chris King are speaking today at the Forum Club. They're all hoping to succeed Governor Rick Scott, who can't run again after 2 four-year terms. He is termed out, as they say. The election is about 14 months away. Among the GOP candidates, Ag Secretary Adam Putnam and Pinellas Senator Jack Latvala. Also, today marks the 54th anniversary of the March on Washington, 1963. More than 200,000 people appeared in the nation's capital to hear Martin Luther King's I Have a Dream speech. The march and the speech both pressured President Kennedy to initiate a federal civil rights bill in Congress. Religious leaders from across the country are planning to honor the anniversary today with the 1,000 Ministers March for Justice.
The meeting he had with the county sheriff. City police.
To the slain civil rights leader installed on the state capitol grounds. It's 8 feet tall. The unveiling of the statue comes more than 3 years after Georgia lawmakers endorsed the project. Negotiations had to be made with the King family for the right to use his image. On to consumer news now. The first sentencing in the Volkswagen emissions scandal, it was big. A Volkswagen engineer that played a key role in the company's diesel emissions scandal has been fined $200,000 and sentenced to 40 months in prison. The judge said the engineer knew that Volkswagen was cheating and worked to cover it up. The sentence was more than prosecutors had requested. Amazon has already announced they'll be lowering prices on a range of food at Whole Foods. And Amazon Prime members have even more to look forward to. As the company completes its purchase of the grocery chain, it plans to unveil an Amazon Prime customer rewards program in the stores. Prime members will get special savings and in-store benefits that other customers won't receive. And by the way, your next question, joining Amazon Prime costs $99 a year. Speaking of food, back to the kitchen now and Chef Judy and her eggplant dish. Judy?
So we have the eggplant that we've taken the moisture out. Now it's been in the oven and we've let it cool just for a little bit. A couple pieces may just fall apart. You can just put that on the edge of your casserole dish, which is going to be fine, okay? So we're going to let that stretch out. We're going to take full ricotta. We don't want to get the low fat kind because we don't want to add any liquid to this. We're going to add some shaved Parmesan, saving some shaved Parmesan just to go with that arugula lemon salad, which is going to be really nice. Now think out of the box a little bit. You can add some sun-dried tomatoes if you want. I mean, this is just going to be really easy and fresh and delicious, so have fun with it, with the things that you like. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a little dab. Well, that's more than a little dab, right? Because that's the best part, is the filling. And we're just going to roll, and we're going to layer this right on top of that tomato, okay? And you see the bright, big pieces of Parmesan cheese. I prefer to use this type of Parmesan cheese for this dish instead of the grated that's very fine, because I really want to taste it as it comes in to the flavor. Eggplant's going to pick up, like spinach, is going to pick up the flavors that surround it. So let's do one more here, and then I'll show you the topping, which is always really good. Okay, there we go. So we have one row done. This is not something you want to layer. Eggplant Parmesan is something you want to layer. But we have these rolls. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a few sun-dried tomatoes, about every other one, and put it on there. And then I'm going to slice some fresh mozzarella cheese. And that's how we're going to do it. This is going to go in the oven just like that. We'll finish it up on break. When it comes out of the oven, look at that. Isn't that perfect? I mean, you can just carry it to any party that you're going to, even down to Sunset, because it can be served at room temperature. Simple arugula salad. Salt and pepper, good quality olive oil, zest of lemon. I think that's really important to get the zest right in there. And then let's cut the lemon open and get a little of that lemon juice in there. Take those seeds out right there so we don't have to worry about them. Catch any other seeds that come down. Look at this, right? Nice, fresh, bright. And that's gonna counter the acid from the tomato sauce. A little olive oil. That alone is gonna stand perfectly, but if you want a drizzle of balsamic vinegar, that's gonna be great too. So let me plate it up, get ready for lunch, and we'll be back in just a few minutes for a taste.
Discover all the reasons the experts love Subaru during the Subaru A Lot to Love event at Sunset Subaru in Sarasota. Nobody beats Subaru in service quality, vehicle quality, and overall quality. And AOT named Subaru the 2017 top brand for residual value. Right now, lease the most fuel-efficient vehicle in its class, a new Subaru Outback, for just $229 a month, or get 0% financing. Get more for your money. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
If you're only hungry for a slice of apple pie, why buy the whole pie? And you certainly wouldn't want to pay for an all-you-can-eat buffet. So if you don't use your cell phone that much, why get charged for a plan that's too big or even an unlimited plan? Luckily, there's still a wireless company that shares your values. Welcome to Consumer Cellular. Our average customer pays about $25 a month for everything they need. Many pay even less, as plans start at just $10 a month. You'll get a straightforward bill that's easy to understand, with no surprises, and all the attention you deserve from our friendly customer service team. No wonder Consumer Cellular has received J.D. Power Awards for highest customer service. Plus, if you're an AARP member, you'll receive special discounts. It's easy to switch. You can even keep your phone and your number. So stop paying for more than you need and start your 30-day risk-free trial today. Call 800-457-2317, go online, or visit a Target store today.
Attention Sarasota and surrounding cities. After 25 years in Sarasota, Bacon's Furniture and Design will be moving to create Southwest Florida's largest and most dynamic furniture store. We must liquidate everything in the store at huge savings as fast as possible. Do not miss this opportunity to purchase quality sofas, bedrooms, dining rooms, patio furniture, mattresses, and more, all at the absolute lowest prices possible. The Bacon's Furniture and Design relocation sell-off. Nobody beats Bacon's.
Start your day with a new Good Morning Suncoast team. Weekday starting at 5 a.m. Now your ABC 7 First Alert weather forecast with meteorologist John Scalzi.
Some more rain showers still in the forecast for today. An 82-degree air temperature with a few showers in progress. Dew point value at the surface, 79. That's really high dew point value, about as high as it gets. And not only at the surface, but this morning's balloon launch at Tampa, Ruskin, reveals that the column of the atmosphere from the ground to the top of the atmosphere, pretty much, is about as wet as it gets. The data value that came in shows a very moist, unstable atmosphere, just really ready to produce showers. So it is certainly possible that we could see more heavy rainfall again this afternoon. Temperatures across the region generally hugging the 80-degree mark, even a few upper 70s still. So consequently, it's going to be a cool day comparative to what we probably will see by Wednesday or so, when we have a little bit more sunshine around. We have some showers in progress here and there across land right now that are not terribly heavy, light to moderate rain falling in most locations, but just offshore of Osprey down through Nokomis, there are some stronger cells just offshore. No thunderstorms here, nothing that heavy, but there certainly are some moderate rain showers moving closer to Nokomis, Venice, on up through Osprey over the course of the next half hour or so. Watch for that if you're in that location and thinking about getting on the roadways. Now, satellite view shows some blossoming clouds with that little bit of sunshine that we're getting, and that will actually help to destabilize our atmosphere just a little bit and maybe help produce some of those stronger storms or at least heavier rainfalls as we head into the afternoon. Severe weather not anticipated, but certainly because the ground is saturated, any additional rainfall, heavy rainfall in isolated locations could lead to some ponding on roadways and certainly aggravate the already existing flooding problems. So down to the south, this is our water vapor imagery. It shows dry air indicated here by tan. Well, that's clearly not over us now. We have the moist air over us now, but some of this dry air will be lifting north with time over the next several days, but not until we finish up with our rainfall amounts, which this computer model shows that by Tuesday comes in at about 2 inches plus. And certainly there could be some isolated pockets if we develop heavier rainstorms that could produce maybe 3 inches plus or so. So we'll watch for that. Stalled frontal boundary helping to encourage the showers. A flow of air coming in around this low pressure circulation of a pre-tropical cyclone or a potential tropical cyclone just off the Jacksonville coast. And then these showers moving onshore with a strong southwesterly flow developing. By the way, there's a rip current issue across our area waterways today as well, especially in the surf zone. Watch for that. Another 2 to 4 inches possible over the next several days. Less rainfall starting tomorrow as we trend down those rainfall amounts. I think we'll see a lot of sunshine and very little rainfall by Wednesday. Another area of tropical concern coming off the coast of Africa. Good chance of that developing down the road about 5 days. Plenty of time to watch it. And of course, the two closer to home. The one I just mentioned. And of course, Harvey's still around. 40 mile an hour winds. Worst possible forecast track for this storm to take. Very, very slowly moving to the north, probably making it onshore by about Wednesday, and in the meantime just slinging tons of tropical moisture across the Houston area. It'll finally eject out of here as we get into probably around the weekend or so. It'll start lifting north toward Tennessee Valley. Our rain chance today, 70%. Decrease it to 50% or so by tomorrow, and then on Wednesday, a mostly sunny day. Back to you, Ray.
Thank you, John. It's always special when someone has a 100th birthday, right? But what about when someone turns 108? Reporter Molly Reed has her story from Ohio.
I'm 108 years old.
For most people, looking back on everything you did in life is part of the fun of getting older. For Valentina Williams, she has 108 years to look back on.
August the 23rd, 1908.
Oh, nine.
When I was born.
Williams was born in Cuba and moved to Youngstown in 1927.
I didn't speak English at all. I only speak Spanish.
Once here, Williams married her husband, James, and together they had six kids that they raised through the Great Depression.
When I was a kid, I used to come, well, I never can compare her to the Blessed Mother, but she was that kind of lady. She followed the Blessed Mother. Implicitly.
Now Williams has 17 grandchildren and 19 great-grandchildren, all of who she gets to watch grow up, and they get to help her celebrate these milestone birthdays.
She has breeded such strong women. Like all of the women in our family, they're very strong-minded. They're very goal-oriented women.
Williams still lives at her house on Selma Street. She's a member of several organizations and an avid church member. All of her family says one of her biggest secrets to staying alive is her faith.
She used to march us to church like ducks. I'm telling you. And you couldn't go to the movies until you went to the 8 o'clock mass.
But William says eating well, staying up to date on current events, and staying active is part of it, too. And she has this piece of advice.
Don't expect too much trouble. You don't get too much trouble. Don't expect nothing and get something.
Very, very wise woman. She was born during the President Taft one term in office back in 1909. That was Molly Reed reporting. Up next, a dubious distinction for the box office this past weekend, and some of the highlights of last night's Video Music Awards wasn't just about music.
During the past 10 years, Tidewell Hospice volunteers have provided more than 1 million hours of service. They sit with patients, giving caregivers a break. They work in offices. They take their furry friends on pet therapy visits. They even clown around. Every task performed by a volunteer makes a difference in the lives of our patients and their families. Join Tidewell's volunteer team. They're truly one in a million. Tidewell Hospice, it's more than you think.
Hi, I'm Chef Bob. Watch Aprons in the Kitchen every Wednesday morning on ABC7, where we'll be serving up the most awesome dishes. Then stop by your neighborhood Publix, pick up the recipe card and all the ingredients.
This is an important medical announcement. Xarelto and Pradaxa have been linked to uncontrollable bleeding and even death. If you've been prescribed one of these drugs and have experienced these dangerous side effects, you may be entitled to substantial compensation. Studies show that Pradaxa can cause more heart attacks than warfarin, and other countries have already issued safety warnings against this drug. Call now for a free assessment of your case and potential money damages. The call is confidential. There's no cost, and you may be eligible. Juries have awarded millions of dollars to Pradaxa victims, and thousands of Xarelto victims are filing their legal cases. Call the Drug Watch Hotline. If you or a loved one used Xarelto or Pradaxa and experienced uncontrollable bleeding, brain hemorrhage, or even death, you must call now.
Call 800-793-6055. 800-793-6055.
Credit card debt can ruin your life. If you owe $10,000 and minimum payments are siphoning away your paycheck each month, you can get debt-free in less time than you think.
I've paid $800 a month for the past 3 years and haven't changed the balance on my credit card.
Get Debt-Free Now has a program to reduce your debt, stop the harassing phone calls, avoid financial ruin, and settle for less than you owe.
I feel like a huge weight has been lifted off my shoulders.
You're pre-approved for our special hardship program if you owe $10,000 or more. Upon payment of your new lower balance, your debt will finally shrink until you are debt-free.
My family no longer has 30 years of payments ahead of us at 20% interest.
There's no fees until you see results. So call now, make one monthly program payment, and free up your cash. Resolve your debt.
Call 800-685-6422, 800-685-6422.
ABC 7 First Alert Hurricane Guide. Download yours today.
So here we have it, the eggplant rollatini, much lighter because we haven't breaded it and fried it. It's going to cut down on the calories, easier to be gluten-free this way. Even if you are avoiding dairy, you can always make a nut cheese, like a cashew nut cheese, and use that instead of the other cheeses. And it's just going to be light and delicious, serves beautifully. And we have that arugula salad with lemon juice and zest of lemon and shaved Parmesan. Now, if you want this recipe, just log on to mysuncoast.com, click on recipes, and it will be there in about 24 hours. And remember, we have a contest every week. Sign up for our culinary newsletter. And if you haven't already, if you have, you're entered in, and every week we pull out a name randomly that's going to win a $50 gift card to our dining page. So check out the dining page, look at the different restaurants that are on our website, click on their websites. You might find wine dinners and special tastings and events that are happening all season long. Enjoy that, and while I enjoy my lunch, I'm going to send it back to you guys.
All right, thank you, Judy. Country music star Chris Young is lending a hand now to help those impacted by Hurricane Harvey. He's giving $100,000 for disaster relief efforts in Texas. He lived in Arlington, Texas, and has family and friends close by. The singer says during tough times, you turn to your friends to help those in need, and that's exactly what he's doing. His donation was made through his foundation. It'll benefit the Red Cross and other disaster relief groups. Well, good news and bad news at the box office this weekend. Hitman's Bodyguard, starring Samuel L. Jackson and Ryan Reynolds, was again the top movie, making $10 million. That's the lowest top movie in more than 15 years. By the way, Annabelle Creation was number two, worth $7 million. And Leap jumped to third with $5 million. And the top five also included Wind River and Logan Lucky. Hip-hop artist Kendrick Lamar had a big night at the Video Music Awards last night, winning 6 awards. The night was also an opportunity to call for equality. Several artists spoke about the debate over the Confederate flag, comments about Confederate General Robert E. Lee, and also an appearance by the mother of a woman who was killed while protesting white supremacists in Charlottesville.
I've been deeply moved to see people across the world, the whole world, find inspiration in her courage.
Other artists reached out to those suffering from depression, Miley Cyrus, Shawn Mendes, and 30 Seconds to Mars also performed. Rod Stewart and Demi Lovato sang remotely from Las Vegas. All right, John, this one's for you. A cool weather phenomenon on Mars. NASA took these pictures a few weeks ago. It shows when the sun began melting the snow and ice that accumulated during the Martian winter. The end result is this pattern of melting ice and red sand dunes underneath it. The Martian ice is actually frozen carbon monoxide, also known as dry ice. To me, it looks like chocolate swirl ice cream.
Yeah, it does, kind of, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Isn't that amazing? There's also at the poles, there's some water there, too, they discovered a few years back. So they're hoping, I guess, someday that maybe they can make use of that.
So all this weather talk in Texas, the tragedy there, has eclipsed what you did last week. You went to Charleston.
Yeah, outside of Charleston, in a place called Greenwood, to see the eclipse.
How was it?
It was amazing. I mean, it was really, really amazing. The difference between totality and a partial eclipse is day and night.
Certainly, literally.
Sorry.
Out there all week.
It's really amazing.
Good. Welcome back. Good to have you
Thanks.
Here. All right, we'll have more tomorrow on Good Morning Suncoast. We'll see you then. Also, Scott's here at 5 o'clock. Have a good afternoon, folks.